class is for commitment change orders in Sage Intacct. In Sage Intacct, commitments and change orders are created in the purchasing application. So you would go to the application switcher here and select purchasing from your list. And then we're going to create subcontract change orders. So there's two ways to do that from this transaction section. We can create a change order from the original document, or we can create a change order just from scratch. We're going to start with creating from the source document of subcontracts. So I'll select that. It brings me a list of subcontracts. Now I can make changes when the status is partially converted or pending. Partially converted means it has been partially invoiced, and pending means it has not been invoiced at all. So we're going to select, let's create a change order for Hanson Plumbing and Irrigation. And so from the source document, I'm going to just select Edit. And that brings me up the information from the source document. Now you see there have been no changes. And so that means that the last change log number is 0. This will automatically increment, so you do not need to change that. I can also look at my items here. These are my original commitment amounts and rows here. I want to create a change order here. And so I'm going to go to More Actions and New Change, Subcontract Change Order. Go ahead and select Leave because I'm not going to make any changes to the subcontract itself. So here's my new change order view, and now you can see the change log number has changed to 1 automatically. So now the next thing to know is that for the date must be earlier than the due date, and it is in this case, so I'm going to leave it. Any fields with a star require entry. So I'm going to go ahead and scroll down to my line items here. Now I can either make a change to an existing row here, or I can add a new row. So here I can say, I'm going to just change this existing row, and I'm going to change it to, I'm going to increase it by 10,000. Now I can decrease it, but I cannot decrease it lower than into a negative amount. So I'm going to add 10,000 here. If I had multiple rows, I would need to add at least a 0 on each of the rows for this change, but there's only 1 row. I'm going to go ahead and add a new row. I don't need to add a document line number. That will happen automatically. So I'm going to go ahead and add it to this same job. I'm going to give it a different cost code. Cost type, we'll call that also subcontract. And subcontract, this is going to be price. I don't need quantities on this one. And I'm going to say 5,000 here. And now I can post or draft. If I draft this change order, I can come back and change it later, but I won't be able to see it on the amounts. So, but then if I post it, I can see it on the amounts for the subcontract, but I then cannot edit it. So now I'm just going to post. Okay, so here is my new, so this brings me to the list of subcontract change orders. And the top one here is my new one, but it does not give me a lot of information. I would like to see more information, so I'm going to add a new view. So first thing you can do is click on this All dropdown and say, what other views are available? Now I can see that there is another view available because it is below this line here. This is a custom view. But so we can either create a new one or we can take a look at existing ones. So we're just gonna look at this existing one. And we can see this one has a lot more information. It has the job number. It has the source document. So this is the subcontract. And then this sub here, this is my change order number. So now this new one that I did, because I have these in order, the new one that I did is now at the bottom. State is closed, meaning that it's posted. And you can see the reference number here. And you can see the amount, which is important to be able to see. If I want to change this view while I am looking at this one, I can go to Manage Views and Edit. So I could add or remove information or change the sort order. So if I go to Edit here, you can see all the existing columns that have information you might want to look at. I'm going to leave those how they are, but we'll just scroll through the options here. So the next thing we would do is on this one, we would decide the order of our columns. Now, actually, I don't want this posted changes total. I guess if I had some that were in draft, I would want to see whether they had been posted or not. So I'm going to leave that. But I can move these around. So I can say, oh, I want the status of this to be before the date. You can just grab these dots here and you can move them around. So then I can say next. This is if I only want this view to show specific items. And you can click here and the columns I had selected, or just the available columns, I can have it only show for specific conditions. I don't have conditions I want to filter on here, so I'm going to say next. This is for sorting. So if you want to sort your view in a specific order, you can move these columns around again and then tell it whether to sort ascending or descending. So maybe I would want the date after my source document, which is my subcontract. Maybe I want date to be descending and then document number ascending. So then I can say next. And that is it. Now, I have already named it. If I had not, if I were creating a new one, it would ask you for a name here. And you cannot change it once you have created it. And you also cannot delete a view. So make sure to give your views names that you wouldn't need to change because you can't delete them. Now, this deploy makes this view available on other screens, which I will show you in a moment. But I'm going to go ahead and save this. And then we can see I have, for this one job, my dates are, it is sorted by dates. It did not save the descending. That is one that you can play around with, but I want to show you how these views can be seen. You do not have to like say, okay, subcontract list and then what view. I can just look at this custom view. As long as I clicked that deploy button, now I can see my view from any menu, actually. Just about any menu. Oh, from the all tab. If there is a view, jobs, custom views, now I can see only the job related ones. So it organizes them by application type, but here I don't have to filter down. I can just say I can go directly to subcontract change orders with amounts. And I believe I should have called that change orders with amount. Manage views, edit. Go to the last step. And it's deployed. Subcontract changers. Sometimes it takes a few minutes to get on the list, and sometimes you need to refresh. So when you've made changes, if you don't see them, you can refresh your page. You can click on up here, or you can just click F5. Now let's go to applications. Custom views. There it is. Subcontract change orders with amounts. Okay, so the next way that we can create commitment change orders is just to create them from scratch. And so I will select from purchasing all subcontract change order. Now I'm back to this list, and you see that I came back to this last list that I viewed. You will always come back. It will remember what the last view is that you used and bring you back, but you can click on this drop down and you can select any other view. If I select all, it brings me back to that original one. So now from this subcontract change order or commitment change order view, I can just click add. Now, there's a lot of information to fill in, and this is the reason that I like to start from the source document. But if I scroll down, I can select the source document here, and I will need to. So let's say 160 again. Now, when I go up to the top, it has filled in all of this information for me. I also have a new changelog number because I posted number 3. So you just want to remember the date needs to be prior to the due date. So in this case, it is not on this one. So if I change this one to 1/31/22, oops, 01/31/22, there we go. Okay, so now I'm going to scroll down here, but now you see that for one thing, when I click this list, it does not give me a lot of information. I don't see the vendor or the job or anything, so it's a little bit harder to see what information is available. Also, I don't see all of my rows from the commitment. But here, I can select here. Now you can see that there used to only be 3 rows. Now there are 4 because I added a new row. But let's say I want to change number 3. Now it fills in all of the existing information for me, but there's no price or anything available, so I also can't see what it was originally. But let's say I want to add $200 there and save it. Now I can see my $200 change here. And if I go back, so that is all there is to do with commitment change orders. They're quite straightforward. Let's take a look now at our subcontracts and see the information that we can view on these. There are not existing reports right now that cover these well, so we'll look at our subcontracts from the views. Now you can see I'm on all, and you can see that there's not a lot of information again. So here I can select. Now here's how I know you can't delete views and you want to name them appropriately, because I was just playing around and created one and now I can't delete it. So let's say that I have one with amounts. I want to look at this other view. And I know these are custom views because they're below the line here. So I want to just, and I can edit these custom views. So now I have this custom view and it's a lot more informative because I have my document number, I have my job and the vendor, and I have my total. This is my original total. These are the changes for this subcontract or commitment, and this is my revised total. So you can do things with these views to give you more information right off the bat, which is really nice. And again, if I wanted to edit this view while I'm looking at it, I can go to Manage Views and Edit. And then I can change, just like I showed you before, it shows you a whole list of what's available, and I can change the sort order, I can filter it, and I can change the column order. So that is all that I have to show about commitment change orders. Thank you for watching.